tonight, Ahmed interviews some pigeons, I eat some fries, Michael stares at the camera, and Nick is going to make interviews of tourists.
Now we are going to make some interviews of tourists.
Exactly, let's go.
The Netherlands, known for its canals, tulips, and definitely not for its depressing and bipolar weather, is also home to Vincent van Gogh, Tommy the Funny Street Man, and some place we don't mention on campus. But what would happen when a Kurd, two Belarusians, and a Chinese gentleman visit the country seeking to film a documentary about the North versus the South? Well, we put that to the test. I have complete faith in my professional staff.
Are you going to be recording?
Yeah, just...
Are you recording?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
No, I'm not sure. I'm not a micro, bro. What are you talking about? I'm not sure.
Okay, maybe I do not. Nonetheless, I started interviewing people not knowing that the Dutch can be quite camera shy.
Oh, actually, he doesn't have micro. What's the point of me talking? Oh, shit.
We were off to a bad start. But then... something really interesting happened.
Our main theme is what it means to be Dutch.
What it means to be Dutch. What does it mean to be Dutch?
Oh, to be Dutch. That's a good question. Because I don't really feel Dutch. It's more, I do feel Limburger, as they say. But being Dutch means, it's a hard question. Living in the Netherlands is gives people a lot of freedom. Everything is possible here if you compare it with other countries. So I think I'm very lucky to be here.
Well, to be Dutch in the first place, it means to be free to do the things you want to do, the things you want to say, and the things you want to express, and in basic, who you want to be. We have a lot of freedom in the Netherlands.
Cheese.
Frikandelbroodje. Energy. That's real life.
Okay, well, other than that, what does culturally make the Netherlands any different from the rest of the neighboring countries?
I don't really care about culture, but yeah. It sucks. It's ugly.
What does it mean to be Dutch? Wow, difficult person. Difficult question. I never think about being like some kind of nationality. I just feel like human. My parents are from Suriname. My grandparents are from India. I was born in the Netherlands, so for me it's like difficult to feel like some kind of nationality. But living in the Dutch feels great, especially Amsterdam.
Here it's a good country to live in, but I especially feel as a person who lives in Limburg or in Maastricht, not especially Dutch.
So what makes a person Dutch?
What makes a person Dutch? I think they're open-minded, they all have their own cultures, and not only in the country but also in the different places. We are proud to be Dutch, but we are also, we're not very close. I think we're proud to be Dutch, but we're open to others.
Homeless.
What are you saying? Are you saying that homeless people have kids?
That's racist.
Stop it!
What do you think makes Southern Netherlands more interesting or different than Northern Netherlands? Since we are considering to go to Amsterdam and find the differences between the Limburg province and Amsterdam.
Okay, well, we always say Limburg is more, how should I say, Burgundic. We know how to celebrate life. Mm-hmm. And that's a difference with the northern of the Netherlands, the south of the Netherlands. It's more relaxed here. We know how to celebrate. Mm-hmm. And, you can see it on how the people, how they are very outgoing, how they dress, how they live outside, how they... as you can see here, how we make our music, how we amuse ourselves.
I think it has more to offer. There's a lot more crowd, it's a lot more interactive. I feel like it's a lot more to do in a small area. It's a lot of shopping. Everything, I think the location is good. It's a center location that has everything, and we don't have to go all over just to find what we're looking for.
It's smaller. I thought it's not as touristic at Amsterdam. It still is, I would say, but not as crazy as Amsterdam. And it's not so crazily crowded, I would say.
Yeah. For you, how do you view the north, like Amsterdam in particular?
How do you feel now? I love Amsterdam. It's one of the cities I visit the most, except for Maastricht. So I actually lived there for a couple of months once. So I really see Amsterdam as the capital of the Netherlands, but Amsterdam is not the Netherlands. It's very different than the rest of the country. So it's like visiting another country within another country.
Yeah, I think Netherlands is a very small country, but the provinces of Holland are quite different. Like the north, Groningen is student area and farmers area. And there is a lot of resources in the ground, like oil and gas. And the south of Holland, Limburg, it's a carnival city. It's a Catholic area, actually, the Limburg part. And they're very warm people to each other. And the north looks a little bit more cold or distant, like, but they're not, but they're just that's the impression.
Maybe some culture difference.
Yes, there is like a culture difference, especially in the north. Dutch people say people from the South Holland they work harder, and people from the North Holland are more like cocky persons. I think that's the main difference, and that's the little war there is between those two areas, especially if you look at sports. For example, you have like Ajax in Amsterdam and Rotterdam as Feyenoord, and these are the main things they are telling when they compare us, these two, with each other.
Not.
Okay, Nick, what did you find in the Mensa orange?
Mensa.
Some substance, bro.
Nutritious.
You want us to die?
Enjoy, bro.
You want us to starve to death?
This is why you shouldn't steal fruit from Mensa.
This is why you shouldn't eat it, Mensa, bro.
It's instant karma, you know? Like, instant karma.
Wait, let me see.
Alright, we're not encouraging you to eat Mensa fruits, but we can definitely encourage you to visit Amsterdam, the city of sin.
Jammin', jammin', and I hope you like jammin'.
Hey guys.
Today we are here again in Amsterdam, day three, and we are at the Van Gogh Museum, a very gorgeous museum dedicated to the life of Vincent van Gogh, a great late Dutch painter. And he is a cult of personality among a lot of people, especially in France for some reason. And we'll find out why.
Yeah. Now we are going to make some interviews of tourists.
Exactly. Let's go. Have you been to the other parts of the Netherlands? Have you been to other places in the Netherlands?
I'm kind of scared to walk here because there are pretty
scary people here.
A lot of drunk people on drugs and all of that. And where we're from, it's kind of more calm and a little less illegal.
A little less.
Yeah.
Do you find any differences between Amsterdam and Eindhoven?
It looks older. I think the people don't really care about how they look here. And if you go to a smaller city, they care more.
I think Amsterdam is fine also. It's just, for lack of a better word, too closed in. And I haven't done much exploring, but I feel like I can see more in Maastricht. Everything is so close-knit in Amsterdam. I would have to know somebody to take me out there to navigate, or I'd have to do my research.
Yeah, we've been to Amsterdam before a couple of years ago, and I mean, yeah, everyone goes there and everyone wants to see Amsterdam. But yeah, on this trip we went to Utrecht and now to Maastricht, and yeah, we wanted to do it on purpose to see something different and something else of the country. And I mean, everyone has seen Amsterdam, so why not choose something new and see something different?
Right. What about you, sir?
Yeah, I fully agree. We just wanted to do something different and some smaller cities, because Amsterdam's everybody is doing that. But I guess there's more in the Netherlands than Amsterdam, so this is why we decided to do that.
So we are there at the Van Gogh Museum. Michael, do you feel excited?
Yeah, I'm very excited. This is the best part of it though.
What about you guys?
Bro,
he doesn't even know who Van Gogh is. What about you?
I'm too excited. I'm gonna piss myself.
Shame,
yes, bro.
It's such a shame.
Dreaming to have a cool lunch, bro, after museum.
He's just thinking of food. Let's go.
Do you like people in Amsterdam and just live in Amsterdam?
If people from Amsterdam live in Amsterdam?
No, do you like them? Like,
they're nice, but yeah, I don't live here, so
not as nice as Eindhoven.
Yeah.
I think the people in the Netherlands are overall nice. I think they're friendly. I think if I were to compare and say that a bunch of people being different from the other, I think, because I've been to France, and I would say, if I'm comparing, I think everybody in the Netherlands are nice, whether it's Amsterdam or Maastricht, or I think I like the people here. I think I prefer the Netherlands over France. I think the people are much more friendly and interactive and just nicer on the whole.
The thing is, the times are changing, and the real Amsterdam people, like the local Amsterdam people, like my grandmother, and it's disappearing because you have a lot of tourists, a lot of people from outside Amsterdam and coming from other cities, from Holland, are living in Amsterdam. So the real culture is a little bit disappearing, but of course I like the people.
I used to, but I think in the last couple of years I've seen a development in Amsterdam where a lot of people originally from Amsterdam moved out of the city. I think one of the reasons is the prices are getting higher and it's not affordable for them anymore. So at this moment, you have a lot of people living in Amsterdam which haven't lived here for their whole life. So it's like more a multicultural city. It's becoming a more multicultural city. with only if you look at the Dutch people. But yeah, I can't complain. I think it's something what's normal. A city, Amsterdam, becomes bigger also for tourists, and I think with that development, prices will go higher automatically, not only for house rental, but I think for all kind of stuff.
Sir, what do you think about the Netherlands? What does it mean to be Dutch? Sir, what does it mean to be Dutch?
I don't think they're willing to participate in
Netherlands. Sir, what does it mean to you to be Dutch? Hey, sir, what do you think of the Netherlands? Sir, we're trying to ask you a question, sir. Good.
Excuse me, sir. What do you think about Dutch?
What the Dutch government? Sir, please don't. Sir. Hey, sir.
This bird out here trying to get some drip. You know what I'm saying?
Nuts.
That's too big.
Do like nuts.
Too big.
So, good afternoon, sir. My name is Ahmed from the United World College Maastricht. Would you like to introduce yourself?
My name's Tommy. I come from Australia. I'm a street performer. I've been doing this about 8 years now, and currently live in Amsterdam.
Right. The performance that we just saw was absolutely incredible. We'd like to thank you for your absolutely amazing performance. How long have you been working as a street performer?
8 years.
8 years.
8 years. I started back in Australia. I would come every 6 months. I would come here for the summer.
Right.
Going back and forth. And eventually I just decided I love the place and now I'm here.
You mean Amsterdam, right?
Amsterdam, yeah.
What do you think of Amsterdam?
It's a very vibrant city, very colorful. The people are generally nice. It's just perfect for me. And the people love my show here, no, so that helps.
That's amazing. How long have you interacted with the people? Like, how immersed are you in the culture?
How do you mean?
So you say you come back here every 6 months or so?
I did, yeah.
You used to do that.
Yeah.
But now you are full-time based in Amsterdam?
Yeah.
Okay. How do you find the city?
Like I said, it's just very colorful. Yes, anybody can be what they want to be here. That's
in contrast to Australia, how do you find it?
Where I come from in Melbourne, it is also very vibrant, but I think here they're much more open. It's hard to say. A lot of people come from where I come from, come here because they find it so similar.
Right.
Yeah. Very liberal, very, a lot of art, music, in both cities, I mean.
I see.
And especially here, you can find people doing gigs everywhere.
Have you tried other countries other than the Netherlands?
Yeah, I've traveled around Europe, Belgium, France, UK, Ireland. I want to explore more of Europe. Now that I'm based here, I can. Yeah.
A few last questions. Mm-hmm. Have you visited other cities in the Netherlands?
I have, but not to do my show.
Right.
I'm able to do my show here because it's less restrictive than other cities.
Right.
But I have wandered around, yeah.
What cities did you visit?
Utrecht, Rotterdam, Arnhem, just a few cities just outside Amsterdam,
right.
Yeah.
Are they any different from Amsterdam?
What do you mean?
Culturally or like linguistically or in any other way?
They definitely speak a lot more English in Amsterdam, I found. But each city is beautiful in its own way, has its own things that it has going for it. It's still very beautiful. I love Netherlands, really.
Thank you so much for your time, Tommy. We really appreciate you, and we hope that you have a nice day.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Great show.
Yeah,
thank you so much. Great show.
Good luck. Have fun. Thank you.
This is a fire-eating stick. Check it out. You can buy this at any fire-eating stick shop. The fuel that I use, this is called lamp oil, or in Mexico, it's called tequila. Now, I'm going to say 1, 2, 3. I'll put some of this fire in my mouth. Okay, when you see me do it, let's all clap together. Everybody in Amsterdam will hear the clapping. We'll get 500 people and we'll attack the palace. But I should say this now before I do the tricks. This is not a magic show. Everything you see is real. I am not a magician. My father, he was a magician. When I was born, he disappeared. Yeah, thanks. kids, anything you see in the show here, please do not try this at home.
Yeah, thank you.
Try it at school. You get a big audience and you get the day off. Before the finale of the show, the sword swallowing, I do one big trick with the fire. I'll throw it up, I'm going to spin and catch behind my back. This is hard, so if I get it, you clap. If I don't get it, don't clap, call me an ambulance, they know who I am.
It's an ambulance right there.
It's not part of the show if my hair is on fire. Don't stand there taking pictures. And Thisa, this is very important. Listen, I'm doing the show by myself. There is nobody helping me. If anybody in the audience tries to leave and they don't give me money first, kill them. like in Paris. Thisa, I'll show you how. Okay, open your mouth, I'll put it inside you.
Open your mouth, I'll put it inside you.
How old are you, Deesa? 16? Shit. Oh. 21, perfect. Deesa! Sorry. I like how I'm doing this, the parents not even trying to stop me. They're filming. Deesa, you have terrible parents. Yeah, I'm not going to make you do that, but please come back over here just for one more thing. We're gonna kill Deesa, yay! It's gonna save us money for college. Deesa, today Deesa, you have the most important job. You are going to pull the sword out of my body.
Oh god.
Welcome to Amsterdam. Deesa, as an example, can you please hold the sword by the handle? Perfect. Now when I say you're pulling it, I am lying a little bit. All I will do is pull myself away from the sword. Okay, so you don't move at all. Okay. I have to clarify a couple of things. Deesa, look at me. No matter how nervous you are feeling, no matter how sadistic you are, no matter how funny it is in France, when you're holding the sword, don't do this, or this, or this. Don't do this. I'm a real person, I'm not a kebab. Deesa, if you kill me, witnesses. He never come to Amsterdam again.
Wait. Welcome back to our Project Week, guys. It's our final night here in Amsterdam, and we're going back to Maastricht tomorrow. What we've learned on our Project Week is that the Netherlands is a very diverse country, and that what better way to appreciate this fine, diverse country than to show our appreciation in our own languages. I'd like to start by saying Zor spas guzarim bo eo Holanda, khalkiki zor rukhosh rukhoshawistin, u hamisha bakhtorben.
Дякую, великі сябри. До нових зустріч. Мені справді вельми сподобалося наше подорожжя. Я відкрив для себе вельми чого нового у Нідерландах, у Амстердамі, у Лімбургу. Це було класно. До зустрічі.
Спасибо большое, Амстердам, за теплий прийом.
Конце гуэй, шалфеєзу, зайдем.
Goodbye. Woo! Nice. Yes, the show is true.
You can turn down the exposure.
How do I turn down the exposure?
Press the focus.
And then? Okay. Yeah, it's it.
Yeah. That's
Cause every day we pay the price. We'll deliver
clap the time.
Okay, guys, what are you thinking about?
Bro, some random guy just approached us and told us if you want cocaine.
That's the second time I faced with this situation. Second time. One time in Red White Streets, second time here at Corner. Shit, guys. Actually, yes, Amsterdam is so crazy. Extremely crazy.
Guys,
I feel like getting crazy in Amsterdam. Because in Maastricht, I always keep it down, but here, yes.
If you don't get crazy in Amsterdam, just don't get crazy ever.
Yeah.
Wait, are we putting this in our project video?
We can do like two videos. One is like project week, and the second is like editor's choice, you know?
Yeah,
the director's choice.
We have a.
It's already telling us what to do. Oh yeah, that's good. Let's just run.
Bro, just imagine. You throw a nut to the road, he goes to take it and car just kill it.
Is it? Repeat it on the
Maastricht
camera.
Maastricht is probably one of the most perfect cities. It has like literally everything for accommodation.
Definitely.
It has nice weather,
absolutely.
Nice people.
Absolutely. This part we should include in the video, for sure.
100%.
It's not an advisement, it's just we show our appreciation.
We really love it.
Yes, definitely.